In this video, I built 5 iPhone apps in just under an hour. I wanted to really put to test how fast development with SwiftUI actually is, so I decided to build 5 basic iOS apps in under 1 hour. This is a best of video. You can find the full 54-minute raw upload linked in the description right below the subscribe button. So the first 2 apps are really basic, and I bet most of you have made apps like these when you got started, as I'm just talking about a to-do list and a notes app. Don't worry, the apps will get more complex as we go along. So let's get started with the to-do app. I created a CoreData project in Xcode, but I removed basically all of the CoreData code, so everything in the content view and a bunch of stuff in the persistence controller. Next up, I started setting up my CoreData entities, so all of the models that I want. And I also generated them manually because that's just faster to iterate on. You can also have the automatic class generation. It's not 100% reliable in my experience, so I just generated the code manually. And then I also added in some examples for my SwiftUI previews. Next, I started by fetching the to-dos from CoreData via the @fetchRequest property wrapper, and then I displayed them in a plain SwiftUI list. I also added a toggle-like button for the done flag of a to-do, so whether it is done already or not. Next, I added a sheet to create new to-dos with a simple text field, a cancel button, which also dismisses the sheet as a secondary button, and then of course also a save button. Already almost done, so most of the things already work. I then also went along and added an onDelete modifier so the user can swipe to delete a to-do from a list row. And that's already it with the first app, the to-do app. Next, I got started with a notes app. Architecturally, very, very similar. So I once again created a CoreData project in Xcode and removed most of the example code from the template. I set up my CoreData entities and I filled the preview with some dummy notes so we have something in our SwiftUI previews. I started by creating a very simple list UI, so in SwiftUI this is just a simple list. And then I also created a second screen to edit the notes. So I had to add a state variable, note content is what I called it, because note.content is optional because it comes from a CoreData managed object. Have a look on my Twitter account to find out about a way to still use these optional values for non-optional bindings. I have a little extension there that could be very helpful. In this case, I just created a state variable note.content that basically gets synchronized with note.content. And then of course I also created a sheet to add a new node. In the end, same as with the to-do app, I added the onDelete modifier, so we have that nice delete swipe action in our notes list. Next, I wanted to create a random image widget, which pulls a random image from an API and displays it in a small square widget on the user's home screen. To try the API out, I created basically the widget inside of the main app, so I just download the data of the image, convert it to a UI image, and then display it in SwiftUI. For that I used Swift Concurrency and the free Lorem Ipsum image API. I did not go for the async image view because that does not work in widgets. And once everything worked, I took the exact same logic, rebuilt it in our WidgetKit extension. So we have a task to download the image data via URL session. Then we pass that optional data to the timeline entry. And then in our widget view, if that timeline entry contains data, so if it's not nil, then we show an image, otherwise we just show a little error message. And that's already it with the third app. It's actually very quick to implement something like this, but it can be actually quite nice to have on your home screen, I think. The next app already got a bit more complex, and that's a calorie tracker app. So same as before, I cleaned up the auto-generated CoreData code, and I created two CoreData entities or classes or models or whatever you want to call them. Meal template, where the user can save, for example, common meals that they eat, and then a logged meal, which is basically where the actual logged food gets saved. That means that we need to have a few different screens, so I added a tab view and a meal template view, which is used to add common meals that you want to track, for example, your breakfast that you eat every day or a common type of lunch or dinner. In my example here, I think I used a burger and a salad or something like that. These templates are then later used to quickly track your calorie intake. For that, I also created the log meal view, which is a list of all meal templates at the top. All of the templates that you previously created, of course. And when you tap one of these templates, you can quickly log that food and those calories for the day. Below that, there is also a second list for all of the logged meals, which is basically your meal history or your calorie history. In the future, this could be the basis for filters and data visualization via graphs and stuff like that. Next, I also created another networking-based app, and that's a news app. So first of all, I created a model for the API response, once again, using Swift concurrency, using newsapi.org as my source. For that API, you need an API key, which is free, but I placed that in the secrets.swift file, so don't worry about it, there is an API key in that project. You just can't see it in this video. And as a little spoiler, I ran into some issues with my model later on, so be on the lookout for that. I'll talk about it more towards the end. Next, I started building the news UI, which is just a simple list. This time I actually used async image because we don't need to have a widget. Inside of the app, async image works just fine. Not the best solution, but it works just fine. Then I also added a title, the author, the article's description, and a link to keep on reading the entire article in your browser. And then lastly, I noticed an issue with my model. So the response is actually not just an array of headlines, which I originally thought. It's actually an object with several properties, only one of them being the headlines. And also, some of the fields don't always have a value, so I had to make them optional, of course. After that, everything worked, and that's already all of the 5 apps that I wrote in under 1 hour. If you enjoyed this type of video or if you want to learn about iOS development, be sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and if you have ideas for future videos or app ideas that I should make, just drop them down in the comments. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.